15 minutes before the hour. Next, Earth, Wind, and Fire.
In the world of popular music, a band has to have something very special to last more than a year or two, and Mark is now here to tell us about one group who has proved somewhat timeless, at least a generation of timeless.
Yes, they have. Kathleen, by any standard you want to use, longevity, hit production, or just plain good vibes, Earth, Wind, and Fire are extra special. They've been at it for 17 years, and they're still going strong.
The soulful, the delightful, energetic, creative. I love them.
It's just the music I live by. And the return engagement means a whole lot to me. I wouldn't miss it for the world.
They just get right down to your bones. They do. They make you rock.
Earth, Wind, and Fire. Their songs bring back memories of rocking, romance, and resounding concert tour success. Hits like That's the Way of the World, Shining Star, and Fantasy made Earth, Wind, and Fire superstars of the 70s. The group won 6 Grammys, sold close to 40 million records, and landed 30 singles on the pop charts. But for the group's leader, Maurice White, it was a time of mixed emotions.
It was fun for me for a period of time. And then after that, it's the isolation is what I didn't like. The late 70s, early 80s was all isolation for me, and I didn't like that.
Yeah, you don't get a chance to really interact with regular people, and the time off gave us a chance to be regular people, to see what everybody else does. You know, like Maurice said, we were isolated. We couldn't go out. Everything we said was always on the news. You didn't have a chance to really breathe, you know.
In 1983, the band quietly disappeared, but this past October, they were back in the studio. System of Survival was the single that took the industry by storm. Their current album, Touch the World, has gone gold, and their latest single, Thinking of You, is not only a hit on the Billboard charts, but with video watchers as well. How did you get back together again?
It was a phone call.
Yeah, phone call. We just talked about primarily one thing. We didn't talk about finances or anything like that. We just talked about wanting to be in the best band in the world. And our whole commitment to one another was from a standpoint of the band being the best it could be, and when it's not, then we would do something else. And I think that we held true to that all the way to the time that we decided to take a break, because when other things started taking priority, we said, well, let's chill out for a while. And now we're back. Music is the priority, and it's great.
Back with a vengeance, too.
The band is known for elaborately staged performances, and their latest is no exception. The 80-city tour, which began in January, will take them through the United States, Europe, and Japan. The production costs over $1 million. So far, they have sold out everywhere. The name Earth, Wind, and Fire comes from the days when Maurice White was studying astrology.
The elements in my charts is earth, air, and fire. There's no water. So I was trying to think of a name of the group, and so I decided to call it Fire, and didn't sound right to me. So the chart was right there, and it had the other two elements. So I said, well, I'll just call it Earth, Wind. I changed wind, air to wind, and there's a name.
For Earth, Wind, and Fire fans, they're thrilled that the band is back as a major element in the music world. This is a hot show, very much worth going to see. Tomorrow night, Earth, Wind, and Fire in Milwaukee, then Chicago, Cleveland, and Cincinnati. Do not miss them when they get to your area. And the fun thing is, when a band normally has a comeback, they're coming back from not being as good as they were. This is not that kind of a comeback. They were great when they left. They're great when they came back.
And they could have been Earth, Air, and Fire.
of any era can match the musical impact Earth, Wind, and Fire made in the 70s, with live shows that were legendary and recording hits like Shining Star, Reasons, and That's the Way of the World. Earth, Wind, and Fire dominated the charts. But in the early 80s, the group disbanded, reuniting in 87 with an album and a tour. Now they're entering the 90s with a new album. It's called Heritage. And we welcome three of the group's original members, Maurice White, Philip Bailey, Verdeen White. Gentlemen, good morning.
Morning.
How you been, guys?
Real good, man.
All's well?
All's well.
You released the single, the title track from the album to coincide with Dr. King's birthday. Why?
Yes. Well, you know, Dr. King being a historian and a humanitarian, we wanted to make sure that we released this single during the time when it would be significant in a sense of bringing together people around the world to do something together at one time.
Yeah. And so the plan was for everybody to play it yesterday at noon,
right? At noon,
right?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Did it happen?
Yeah, a lot of people played it before.
You know? They jumped the gun on it.
Yeah, they did.
The new album marks a departure for you guys, in that instead of the basic Earth, Wind, and Fire sound, now you got a little hip-hop on it, you got a little rap on it, you got the Boys on it, you got MC Hammer on it, you got Sly Stone on it. Why?
Because all these people are great. The Boys reflect today, MC Hammer reflects today, and Sly is a legend, is, you know, his own time. Right. Go ahead, Phil.
And we're redefining, too, our market again. We're really being reintroduced to people that and fans that perhaps know about Earth, Wind, and Fire but weren't that familiar with the music.
What are you telling me? It's a little bit of a commercial aid to have these other folks join you?
Oh, it helps out. It definitely helps us out because there's a whole age gap of people that actually were like really kids when we were doing our music.
Yeah. Maurice, I saw where you said that Heritage is street-oriented. Help me out. What do you mean?
Well, with the beat, you know, we're like more or less employing the new technology with the beat. And, of course, you know, using the rap syndrome, you know, that helps.
You going along reluctantly?
No. Uh-uh. It's part of the culture now, you know.
Let's go ahead and we'll take a look at a clip, the title song.
Right, Heritage.
From Heritage.
Right.
Watch this. I asked this because you guys were viewed as the original crossover giants.
Yeah.
Is this album geared basically towards an urban black audience?
Yes, primarily it is. But of course, with Sly Stone being on the record, of course that lends it towards more of a pop audience too.
Yeah. Uh-huh. But do you expect it to be received in that fashion? I mean, I know, for example, Philip, you've been outspoken on the politics of race and radio. What are the realities of it?
Well, the realities are you have your market. And I think that if you start with a real strong base that it crosses over, your chances are greater than to target yourself after a pop market and then kind of get left out in the cold if it doesn't happen.
Does it bother you that you have to think about that rather than just go ahead and make music?
Well, I mean, that's just a reality, though. It bothers you, but if it bothers you to the extent that you can't create, then, you know, it kind of defeats the purpose. But we definitely do have to think about that. I mean, and it's just a fact that you have to think about it, and it's something that a lot of other artists don't have to think about, but we do.
In the 70s, you guys, you were hungry, you were challenged.
Still hungry.
Yeah.
Why? I mean, you're
financially... That's an attitude.
Well,
that's an attitude.
Wait a second, Maurice. You're financially secure.
Yeah,
you
are maybe.
Critically comfortable. You don't need this like you used to.
Yeah, well, you know, it's part of my career, though, you know. So you still need it. You still need it.
The edge.
You need the edge.
You want to be in it. You want to be in the game. You want to do it because it's your life's work.
Why? Because you see it happening around you and you just...
And you love it. You really, you have the passion for it. And I mean, I know when we stay home, all of a sudden we're calling each other. We want to rehearse. Let's work on some songs. Let's get into the game. Because after a while, it's just about your life's work.
But in a critical sense, can Heritage do anything for Earth, Wind, and Fire that you haven't already accomplished?
Yeah, it can reach a new market that we never reached before. Yeah, it can. For us. And I mean, we need that right now.
You are picking up and you're coming back with all the problems attendant to that. How many of you ever wish you hadn't called a halt to it back when you did?
I don't think I'd do it. I think I'd do it the same way.
Yeah, really? The same way.
Why? You needed the break?
I needed the break, man.
Yeah. It was a long time, You work, you're at the top for a long time. And it's a lot of work. It's a lot of strain. It's a lot of stress. You're traveling a lot.
And you have to take a break to get a perspective.
Yeah.
You
know? And live.
Yeah. Put your life on the shelf, you know.
Guys, welcome back.
Thank
16th
you.
Album. It's Heritage. It's always a pleasure seeing you, Vernon.
Thank you very much. Take care of yourself, Phil.
All right. Maurice, stay well. Good luck with your Broncos, Phil. I know you're a big Coloradan. We're going to come back in just a moment. Some final notes for Tuesday morning after.